Hey everyone, this is Christina in Tennessee again. A little while ago I showed you what it was like to pull the second paddleboard. It's my son Nathan up here. I just wanted to kind of show you. We don't have anything pretty right now. We just kind of had a rope here in the back of the paddleboard, and so I just strung it on there as best I can. We have found that you have a little bit more stability without the jackknife effect if you can hook onto those O-rings right up here. If you can hook onto those O-rings, and again, this is not pretty. My husband said he's gonna do something better, but I bet somebody can come up with something better than mine. So we've just come out of a really cool creek back there that we took our rudders off. So we're gonna be doing this with no rudders. And I'm hoping that my son Nathan can steer for me up here. All right, Nathan, you're on. Here we go. And we're off. Yeah, and I can actually steer us. Okay, so even though we don't have any rudders, it seems that I'm decent at steering over here. Not great. Definitely can steer a little better with a rudder. But we are definitely making do. And this is all still kind of new for me. I've probably honestly had these out, I'm gonna guess, 10, 12, 13 times just in the last couple of weeks. We have had an absolute blast. You can take off the rudder and go some places that are super shallow, which we just did, or you can leave your rudder on, which helps control the boat just a little bit better. The whole reason that I bought this setup in the first place is because I'm the kind of grandma. See, what kind of jackknifes here a little bit. Let me slow down a little bit. Yeah, you see if you can get us turned around. There you go. So I'm the kind of grandma that likes to do things with the grandbabies. And I bought two seats. And my son's not actually using his seat. He's actually sitting on the top of it right now. But I bought these specifically so that I could take them out on the water with me. And I still think it's going to be a little easier to pull them. And I do realize that these have been created specifically to push the one in front of you. And again, the problem may very well be that I'm not able to tie it tightly enough right here. So maybe somebody's got a better way of doing this than I do right now. As soon as my son gets us turned around here, we'll turn the motor back on. So here we are while I'm pushing the paddleboard. I did one a few minutes ago where I was pulling the paddleboard. I'm having a hard time getting this tight enough. I'm thinking if I could find some way to get it tighter, it would be a little easier. This is a fine setup if the person in front of you can kind of keep it from jackknifing. Right now I can't paddle because I'm holding a phone, but when both the person in front and the back can kind of steer just a little bit like Nathan's doing there with his paddle, it's pretty easy to keep it straight. And again, the jackknife effect that we have sometimes happen to us, especially if we get going too fast, that probably could be alleviated if we had a better system for tying them together. All right, Nathan.
Yeah.
I said, show them how we jackknife sometimes. So you can kind of see how we're up. Oh, here we go. And then when one boat kind of goes up on top of the other. So
and then we have an infinite circle.
So I'm gonna turn it off, and then we gotta get all straightened back out again and try it all over again. So if somebody has a better way of tying this, then I am absolutely all ears. But again, it's not very hard not to jackknife as long as both people have an oar. You can just kind of drag it in the water and control your spin. So right now we're a little crooked, and that is only because I am not able to paddle right now. So Nathan's gonna try to get us straightened out here. And again, it's just because I'm using my phone instead of using my paddle that we're kind of having some more jackknife issues than usual. So, you know, either which way, you can push, you can pull. Say hi, Nathan.
Hey.
This is Christina signing off in Tennessee. Everybody, I just wanted to show you how this kind of sets up. Now, this is the battery. So I have a marine battery in here. And for comfort, generally, I will just take this life jacket here and I'll kind of make myself a little seat out of it, and I'll just lean up against it. And this is the ultralight, super light, whatever battery, whatever trolling motor that they sell that goes with this. And I love this motor because it is so light that even with the contraption that my husband built, they have the specs for this online. It is so light that it's a piece of cake for me to do. And then what we did is we just, I don't know if you can see that or not, we just bolted it down right here with a those little ropes. Super, super, super easy. No problem at all. Hey, Nathan, come over here and video. I was going to show them how easy this is to tilt. Just keep going. This is so good. So basically, to get it out of the water, you just tilt it. And I can do this from the boat as well. You just tilt it, and then you can raise it up with this little piece right here. That's all there is to it. And then you can just unhook it here on each side. And you just pick the whole thing straight up and put it in your car. All right, go ahead and push stop. Thank you. Hey everybody, Christina from Tennessee again. Just wanted to show you how easy it was to put your paddleboard on top of your car. I have a high van. So the first one goes on right side up. If you have two, the first one goes on right side up without the fin so that your two little small rudders up front won't touch anything. And I have found that for wind resistance, it's best to put the butt of your paddleboard to the front. And that's all there is to it. Take the other one, put it upside down, and you're good to go. Thanks.